And in the poem Africa, we can come to note that the poem has only one stanza. Only one stanza, but it is having 24 verses. So that's all about the form of the poem. And the poem, it is a modern type of a poem because it does not follow the traditional rules of poetry, which are like equal number of syllables in each verse, also equal number of verses in each stanza, and also the rhyming pattern, whereby there is a consecutive voices at the end of each verse. So we are also going to analyze the tone and the mood. And when we're talking about the mood, it is the atmosphere in the poem, the atmosphere found in the poem. It means that if when we read the poem, we find a certain atmosphere that is emotional or whatever, we are going to comment on that atmosphere as the mood of the poem. Now, can anyone try to mention the tone and the mood found in the poem Africa? The tone. Let us begin with the tone. What is the attitude of the persona in the poem Africa? The attitude.
Well, the tone of the persona, it is of patriotic.
Yeah. So, because we are talking about the tone as being an attitude of the persona in the poem, when we read the poem Africa, we realize that this persona, the person or the voice speaking in the poem, it is a patriotic person. He is a patriotic. He or she is a patriotic person. So, therefore, we get the attitude that this person is having a patriotic attitude. So, the tone, it is going to be patriotic. When the poet was trying to compose or to write this poem, what atmosphere was he in? Yes, Walter. Yes, and
the mood of the poem is his poem.
Yes. Please, will you clap hands for him? Now, the mood and the tone, they change, varying due to different circumstances. And in the poem, we can see that there are certain musical features that have been used. And when we talk about the musical features, we mean that the features which create a musical environment in a poem, that the poem maybe can be sung in a certain way, or the poet has used certain creativity in trying to mold his poem so that it can become better and much better. Now, what are the possible musical features? When we talk about musical features, any musical features that we can note in the poem Africa. Yes. Welcome, Evans.
Actually, right from the poem, it is apparition. The French, it involves the figure of speech, which involves the repetition of similar consonant sound at the beginning of words in the verse. As it is seen in the verse, your beautiful black blood that you get. It is explained that the black blood is repeated for the alphabet letter B, it is repeated sequentially throughout the verse.
Yes. So in the poem, we can get to note there is a musical feature termed as alliteration. Alliteration is the repetition of similar consonant sounds, and this it is at the beginning of words in a particular verse or a line. As Evans has given an example, he has given an example in the verse 7, whereby the persona says, "You are beautiful blood that flows in my veins." So here we can see that there is a repetition of similar consonant sounds at the beginning of the verse. We can see that this sound, it has been repeated. So this is to say that among the musical features found in the poem, it is alliteration. Also, there are other musical features that are also found in the poem. Other musical features can include consonants and also repetition. Yes, now, what is consonants? What do we get to? What do you understand by the term consonants? Yes, welcome, Emmanuel.
Well, consonants is the figures of speech which involve similar consonant especially at the end of the verse.
So this we can find it in verse 18. In verse 18, the persona says, impetuous son, that tree, young and strong. Impetuous son. We can note that there is a repetition of the voice of this voice at the end of words. And this is what we term to be consonants, because it is the repetition of similar consonant sounds at the end of words. Repetition, we can simply term repetition that there has been a repetition of the word Africa in the poem, and this is due to particular reasons. Can someone please try to explain? Why did David Diop decide to repeat the word Africa for a number of times in the poem Africa?
The poet David Diop has repeated the word Africa in the poem so as to show emphasis.
Yes, we look up hands for him. So in the poem we note that there is repetition of the word Africa, and as Ishva has commented, that the poet has decided to repeat the word Africa so as to put emphasis in the poem. And by doing so, it means that he has done two things at the same time, whereby he has put emphasis and also he has been showing the relevance of the content of the poem together with the title of the poem. Now we are going to discuss the things is the central idea that is conveyed in a particular poem. So can someone? Can someone try to comment? What is the major theme? The major theme in the poem Africa. The major theme. Okay. The major theme we can just say simply, just to give light. It is in the poem Africa, the major theme it is patriotism, whereby we can see that the persona who we have already commented that is a black activist is a person who is in love with the continent Africa. And therefore, our major theme is going to be patriotism. As it can be noted in the verse 2, where the persona says, Africa, my Africa. And this is to show that he loves Africa and therefore he's patriotic to his continent, Africa. We are going to also discuss about the minor themes. The minor themes, there are a number of them. Now, can you give your suggestions? What other themes can you get from the poem Africa?
Other things that can be called in the poem Africa is humiliation. As the poet says, if this you, this back that is made, this back that breaks under the way of humiliation.
So we can please clap hands for him. He has tried, he has really tried. And we can see that there is humiliation in the poem Africa, whereby as evidence, he has given an evidence of humiliation. Other themes can be slavery, oppression, and also nationalism. So, by doing so, we are going to discuss the message of the poem. The message. The message, we can say that the message of the poem is directed to the Africans. It is directed to the Africans because the poet, David Manisi Dio, is trying to explain or to show that Africa has faced humiliation, oppression, and slavery. And therefore, Africans must work harder in order to make their continent to grow, although patiently and obstinately, as we can see in verse 23. Also, we are going to discuss about the relevance of the poem. The relevance. Is the poem relevant to our current community? Yes, welcome someone.
Thank you.
according to me, the poem is relevant to the society by two major reasons. First, African countries are still exploited indirectly, especially by the imperialist countries during colonialism. Second, African countries are still developing, so according to me, the poem is relevant to the society.
Will you clap hands for him? So the poem is relevant because until now, to the current time, African countries are still developing. As in the poem, verse 23, the poet the person is saying that that is Africa, your Africa, that grows again patiently and obstinately. So the African countries are still growing again patiently and obstinately. Also, there are still some people, also Africans themselves, who are still oppressed and humiliated and whatever. So we can say that the poem, it is relevant to our current society.
To know that the poet David Malesi Diop has used a simple language that is easy to understand and easy to grasp the meaning, to understand the poem. But aside from that, apart from that, the poet has used different figures of speech. And these figures of speech are different. Can anyone try to give at least one figure of speech that we can get in the poem? Any figure of speech that have been used, which has been used in the poem.
Thank you. An example of figure of speech that is used in the poem Africa is personification. When the person says, when the grave answers me.
Clap hands for him. So we can see that in the poem there is the use of personification, whereby personification it is a figure of speech that provides, it gives human attributes to non-humans. Now we can see that in verse 17, the persona says, but a grave answers me. Now a grave is a non-human. Now how can it answer a human being? So there we get to know that the poet has used the personification, giving the human attribute of speaking to a grave, which is an unhuman.
The persona says, this bark that breaks under the weight of humiliation. By saying so, it means that he is bringing a certain picture to the one who is reading or listening the poem, so that he can get a particular feeling, and therefore that is imagined. Also, we can talk about symbolism. Symbolism, whereby this involves the use of things as symbols to represent other things. We can see that the poet has used this symbolism in different aspects, like the word blood. Blood has been used as a symbolism to show or to explain the rate or the extent of suffering that has been experienced by Africa and its children. And this can be noted when the person says, the work of your slavery, the slavery of your children. The blood of your sweat, the sweat of your work, the work of your slavery, the slavery of your children. Also, there is the use of apophthegm. And apophthegm, which is the figure of speech that involves the use of harsh words. And this can be verified in verse 14, whereby the persona says, This mark that breaks under the weight of humiliation. Now he has used the certain sounds to explain or to show harshness experienced by the victim. And we can see that in this verse, this bark, the bark that breaks. These are harsh sounds that have been used in the poem as a figure of speech to also symbolize or to present harshness. And this is all about cacophony. And afterwards, we are going to... we are going to discuss another figure of speech, another criteria, and that is the success and the failures of the poem. Now, the poet has succeeded in some things, and although he has failed in some aspects also, we can note that
The poet has succeeded in composing a poem, the poem Africa, putting it in its a simple language that is rich in figures of speech. As we know that poetry is different from the other literary genres like novels and plays, because poetry it has a specific, a distinctive characteristic of being rich in the figures of speech. Therefore, the poet has succeeded because he has employed the use of figures of speech richly in the poem, and therefore characterizing it as a special and unique poem. As we have noted that there are different figures of speech, because these are not the only figures of speech that have been used, personificating, imagining, whatever. As you read the poem, as you repeat it, day by day, time by time, it comes to your heart. And like me, I've got a number of figures of speech which I cannot, we cannot finish, by the way. So we are going to discuss also the failures of the poet. The poet has also failed in some aspects, and because he has used a modern type of poem, he has composed a modern type of poem that does not follow the rhyming pattern and whatever. Now, because the rhyming pattern isn't present, it means that it is hard somehow for the poem not to be sung. Therefore, if he could have used a rhyming pattern, it means it would have been easier, much more easier, for people to sing the song, the poem, as a song. And therefore, by singing the poem, it will stick to the heads and to the memory. Now, this marks the end of our lesson, and I believe you have enjoyed it. And as you read the poem Africa, you will get more things concerning Africa, because the poem, it is giving us a message, and it is relevant to our current society. Therefore, I believe you have enjoyed the lesson, and if there is any question, any place that you have not understood well, so that we can discuss before I leave, so that the poem can be clearly understood to you. Yes, thank you a lot, and I think the poem has been understood crystal clear. Thank you. Then, until the next lesson.